Idi Amin, or Dada Omi, was a Ugandan military officer who served as the president of Uganda from 1971 to 1979. Popularly known as the Butcher of Uganda, he is considered one of the most brutal despots in world history. Amin was born in Koboko, to a Kakwa father and Lugbara mother. In 1946, he joined the King's African Rifles Corps of the British Colonial Army as a cook. He rose to the rank of lieutenant, taking part in British actions against Somali rebels in the Shifta War and then the Momo rebels in Kenya. Uganda gained independence from the United Kingdom in 1962, and Amin remained in the armed forces, rising to the position of major and being appointed commander of the Uganda Army in 1965. He became aware that Ugandan President Milton Obote was planning to arrest him for misappropriating army funds, so he launched a military coup in 1971 and declared himself president. During his years in power, Amin shifted from being a pro-Western ruler, enjoying considerable support from Israel, to being backed by Libya's Muammar Gaddafi, Zaire's Mobutu Sese Seko, the Soviet Union, and East Germany. In 1975, Amin became the chairman of the Organization of African Unity, OAU, a pan-Africanist group designed to promote solidarity among African states. Uganda was a member of the United Nations Commission on Human Rights from 1977 to 1979. The UK broke diplomatic relations with Uganda in 1977, and Amin declared that he had defeated the British and added CBE to his title for conqueror of the British Empire. Radio Uganda then announced his entire title, His Excellency President for Life, Field Marshal, Alhaji Dr. Idi Amin Dada, VC, SO, MC, CBE. As Amin's rule progressed into the late 1970s, there was increased unrest against his persecution of certain ethnic groups and political dissidents, along with Uganda's very poor international standing, due to Amin's support for the terrorist hijackers in Operation Entebbe. He then attempted to annex Tanzania's Kajer region in 1978, so Tanzanian President Julius Nyerere had his troops invade Uganda. They captured Kampala on the 11th of April 1979 and ousted Amin from power. Amin went into exile, first in Libya, then Iraq, and finally in Saudi Arabia, where he lived until his death on the 16th of August 2003. Amin's rule was characterized by rampant human rights abuses, political repression, ethnic persecution, extrajudicial killings, nepotism, corruption, and gross economic mismanagement. International observers and human rights groups estimate that between 100,000 and 500,000 people were killed under his regime. Amin did not write an autobiography, and he did not authorize an official written account of his life. There are discrepancies regarding when and where he was born. Most biographical sources claim that he was born in either Koboko or Kampala around 1925. Other unconfirmed sources state Amin's year of birth from as early as 1923 to as late as 1928. Amin's son Hussein has stated that his father was born in Kampala in 1928. According to Fred Deco, a researcher at Makerere University, Amin was the son of Andreas Nyabire, 1889 to 1976. Nyabire, a member of the Kakwa ethnic group, converted from Roman Catholicism to Islam in 1910 and changed his name to Amin Dada. He named his firstborn son after himself. Abandoned by his father at a young age, Idi Amin grew up with his mother's family in a rural farming town in northwestern Uganda. Deco states that Amin's mother was Asa'at, 1904 to 1970, an ethnic Lugbara and a traditional herbalist who treated members of Buganda royalty, among others. Some sources have also described Amin as being of mixed Kakwa Nubian origin. Amin joined an Islamic school in Bombo in 1941. After a few years, he left school with only a fourth grade English language education, and did odd jobs before being recruited to the army by a British colonial army officer. Gender historian Alicia Decker wrote that the deeply embedded culture of militarism in Uganda is undoubtedly Amin's most enduring legacy. His reputation in Uganda has been viewed over the decades following his rule in more complex ways than in the international community. Some Ugandans have praised him as a patriot and supported his decision to expel Asians from the country. At the time of his death, he was particularly well regarded in northwestern Uganda. One of Amin's sons, Jafar Rimo, criticized the negative public perception of his father and called for a commission to investigate the veracity of the abuses committed under his rule. Thanks for watching. I would end here and continue in my next episode. Subscribe, like and share with friends and family to promote the channel.